Hi guys, welcome to 1 to 3 episodes recap of the K-drama Connect. With a plot spoiler alert, let's get to it. As the episode starts, we are introduced to Dong-soo. As Dong-soo walks alone in an empty alley, he gets abducted by two men. Apparently, they are from an organ trafficking organization and take Dong-soo to a lab to take out his organs. Surprisingly, after taking out the eyes, they turn to watch the doctor, and Dong-soo starts to see the doctor taking out his organs. The doctor also notices that the eyes look as if they are watching him. The doctor gets a call, and as he answers it, weird tentacles emerge from Dong-soo's body, and he begins to heal. After the call, the doctor notices Dong-soo walking around without his eyes. Dong-soo manages to get one of his eyes, and the doctor, seeing everything that was happening, starts screaming for help. So Dong-soo runs away with just one eye. While sleeping after the incident, the doctor dreams of throwing Dong-soo's dismembered parts. But the parts come to life and begin to follow the doctor. He wakes up from the dream and realizes that the incident is similar to the urban legend Connect. So he asks the internet communities for details about the legend. Hae-in, who is a web novelist, responds to it, claiming that she has looked into the legend for her new web novel, and asks the doctor to share information about it with her. One morning, people notice a statue displayed on the side of the road. Suddenly, blood starts dripping from the statue, so they realize that it is not an artwork, but a real person. So they report it to the police. Among the gathered crowd is Dong-soo with an eye patch, and watches as the police arrive and take the body away. Examining the body, the detectives find that the letters P and L have been carved into the body, just like an artist puts a signature on the painting. Then we see Dong-soo at his house, and he plays the guitar and uploads videos on YouTube. He suddenly starts seeing things that are there around him. He realizes that the eye he left the day he escaped from the lab was transplanted to someone else, and he is now seeing what that person is seeing. The police come across another male that has been murdered and had been displayed as a statue. The investigation is led by Detective Choi, together with Detective Park and Detective Yeom. They notice the murderer tears the flesh to deliberately let the blood drip. Detective Choi decides to analyze the resin used on the bodies and track his seller. Dong-soo works at a junk shop. The junk shop's owner's wife starts to worry about her husband leaving with a handcart. So Dong-soo decides to go look for him. He sees the owner being bullied by some high school boys, so he quickly gets to him and tries to take him away from there. Because the owner manages to escape, the boys start to beat up Dong-soo for helping him escape. They try to scare him with a knife, but to their annoyance, Dong-soo doesn't tremble as they hoped. To their shock, Dong-soo doesn't move away from the knife, so his earlobe gets severed. As Dong-soo holds out his severed earlobe, the three boys run off, calling him a monster. Dong-soo tears up, remembering him falling off a tree when he was a child. As his friends watch his body starts to heal, they run off from him, calling him a monster. Big Guy, who is a member of the organ trafficking organization, overhears the three boys talking about Dong-soo. So he reports it to the organization, and the gang leader Mr. Kim orders his men to find Dong-soo. Hae-in has placed a tapping device in their office, and listens to Mr. Kim talk about Dong-soo with his right-hand man Min-sook. Dong-soo, on the other hand, continues to see the things the other person who is with his eyes seeing. Every time Dong-soo sees from his missing eye, both he and the person who got the transplant gets an uncontrollable pain in that eye. So Dong-soo decides to take back his eye. He decides to go to the organ trafficking organization. When he gets there, Kyung-pyo, who is one of the men who abducted him, goes after him. Hae-in also sees them chasing. Dong-soo manages to run past an oncoming train, so Kyung-pyo and his men get laid behind. Hae-in quickly gets to him and leads him to a dead end. She then cut his leg, saying she wants to confirm something, and excitingly watches as the wound heals. When she hears Kyung-pyo and his men nearing, Hae-in throws Dong-soo off the edge and helps him escape. A musician named Z gets interested in Dong-soo's recent popular song, which is copyrighted free, and decides to use its lyrics and record his own song. We then see Jin-seop, who is the serial killer who kills people and displays them as statues. His latest victim is a child whom he displays as a statue. He works at a company with Sun-hee, who tries to impress him. As she walks with him, Sun-hee starts to hum a song by Dong-soo, and suddenly Jin-seop starts to get the pain, and Dong-soo starts seeing things around Jin-seop. Apparently, it is to him Dong-soo's eye was transplanted. He sees Sun-hee in the building around him, and Dong-soo recognizes the place. Detective Yeom reports to the other detectives that there is a fan base for the serial killer, admiring his artistic sense. Later that day, Dong-soo again gets the pain and sees his Jin-seop blotting off a notebook. To Dong-soo's horror, he notices the notes are about the recent corpse art. So Dong-soo realizes the person who took his eye is the serial killer. Detective Choi, on the other hand, noticed Dong-soo among the crowd in a photograph taken at the crime scene where the woman was displayed. Dong-soo waits at the building he recognized from Jin-seop's vision. As he waits, he takes out the eye patch for a bit, and Sun-hee sees him without the eye patch as she walks with her friend Ji-young. The two women get scared of Dong-soo, and as he tries to ask Sun-hee about the man he was with, the two women runs away from him. Sun-hee and her colleagues notice Jin-seop at a restaurant during lunch hour, and decide to join him. Jin-seop again hears the song Sun-hee was humming the other day, and he gets the pain. So Dong-soo sees the restaurant Jin-seop is in with Sun-hee. Just as Dong-soo gets to the restaurant Jin-seop leaves it, and they even bump into each other. Ji-young and Sun-hee notice Dong-soo at the restaurant, so Mong-han, who has a crush on Sun-hee and seeing her tremble, demands Dong-soo to leave when he asks Sun-hee about the man who was sitting in front of her. At home, Dong-soo tries to see from his missing eye, and wonders why he can only see from that eye randomly. Dong-soo then sees an advertisement for an astrological horoscope, and remembers seeing Jin-seop using it. So he goes to the astrology center. He notices the symbol that looks like a merged P&L in the chart, and remembers seeing it in Jin-seop's notebook. So he asks the astrologer Young-run about it, and whether the days he saw in Jin-seop's notebook have any connection with it. Young-run tells him that the symbol represents Pluto, and the dates are when planet Pluto and Venus are in the same boundary, which is known as a conjunction. Because Pluto represents death and Venus represents art, it could be interpreted as both death and art appearing at the same time. Dong-soo learns the dates future conjunctions will happen from Young-run. Young-run informs about Dong-soo's visit to Detective Choi, and that the symbol is not P&L, but represents the planet Pluto. She recognizes Dong-soo when Detective Park shows her a photo of him as the man who came to see her. So Dong-soo becomes a suspect in the case. At night, Jin-seop gets a surprise visit from Sun-hee. When he wonders how she came to know of the place he lives, Sun-hee admits that she knows everything about him. So he invites her over and spends the night with her. Sun-hee wakes up at night and goes around the house. She sees Jin-seop's notebook and all the drawings of the recent corpse art. She realizes that Jin-seop is the serial killer. The next day, another corpse art gets discovered in a grass field. Dong-soo too arrives at the crime scene. Kyung-pyo and his men, who are also at the scene, notice Dong-soo and chase after Dong-soo, and the detectives also go after them upon seeing them chasing after Dong-soo. To Dong-soo's surprise himself, he manages easily dodge the punches and fights one of Kyung-pyo's men. But Kyung-pyo gets to him and cuts off his arm, and watches as Dong-soo's arm gets reattached and healed. He then calls Dong-soo a connect. Hae-in gets to them and tasers Kyung-pyo and knocks him unconscious. On hearing Detective Park fighting the big guy, Dong-soo and Hae-in run off. Hae-in admits that he followed Kyung-pyo and his men, as she assumed that they will lead her to Dong-soo. She shares her number with him and follows after him, saying that she's not interested in making money from him. Sun-hee gets shaken up on seeing the news of the fourth corpse art, and remembers seeing it on Jin-seop's notebook. So she goes to Mong-han asking for help. She then waits for Jin-seop to talk to him privately, and takes him to the rooftop where Mong-han is hiding, and informs him about seeing his notebook when she was at his house. Jin-seop overhears when Mong-han's phone suddenly starts to ring. The manager in the meantime wonders where Sun-hee and the others are, so Ji-young decides to make a call to her. As Mong-han tries to explain the reason he's hiding, Jin-seop knocks Sun-hee unconscious, and starts to attack Mong-han. Sun-hee gets a call from Ji-young as Jin-seop pulls Mong-han at the edge of the building, and Jin-seop starts to get the pain in the eye, since Sun-hee's phone ringtone is Dong-soo's song. So Dong-hee sees Mong-han trying to fight Jin-seop. He even feels the punches Jin-seop takes from Mong-han. Just as Sun-hee regains her consciousness, she sees Jin-seop throwing Mong-han off the building. Ji-young too sees Mong-han falling off the building through the window. Terrified, Ji-young runs off to find Sun-hee. In the meantime, Dong-soo sees Jin-seop killing Sun-hee. Jin-seop also realizes that his eye starts hurting because of the song. Ji-young and the manager get to the rooftop and find Sun-hee dead. Dong-soo, on the other hand, overhears the employees the department Mong-han works in. He manages to sneak into the building. Jin-seop, who is also coming down the stair, overhears Dong-soo running up. He waits for him to enter the office and rushes into the men's restroom. Dong-soo recognizes his coat as Jin-seop hurries and follows after him. But he mistakes a different employee for Jin-seop. Jin-seop, who is in the toilet, overhears as Dong-soo lashes out at the other employee that he saw what he did. He realizes that Jin-seop is in the toilet. As Dong-soo tries to get in, Jin-seop stabs him with a pen. The other employee calls security on Dong-soo, so Dong-soo tries to grab onto Jin-seop's shoe, as he gets pinned to the floor. Jin-seop sees Dong-soo's wound getting healed. Everyone thinks that it was Dong-soo who killed Mong-han and Sun-hee. Jin-young even recognizes him as Sun-hee's stalker. As the security takes Dong-soo away, Hae-in gets to him and tasers the officers, and helps him escape. Jin-seop, on the other hand, realizes that Dong-soo knows everything about him, but doesn't know what he looks like. He briefly connects his eye transplant and Dong-soo missing an eye, and wonders if the transplant has anything to do with Dong-soo knowing everything about him. Detective Park and Detective Choi investigate Sun-hee and Mong-han's death. Even though everyone claims Dong-soo to be the murderer, the detectives notice Dong-soo entered the building after Mong-han fell off the building. The two detectives get suspicious about Jin-seop and decide to question him. Ji-young, on seeing them, lashes out at the detectives for questioning the wrong man. Detective Choi notices Jin-seop getting uncomfortable when Jin-young passes a white line, and moves her out of the line, trying not to gain attention. Hae-in follows Dong-soo to his house. Hae-in confesses to him the reason she's trying to find out about connects is because once a boy who was a connect saved her when she was young and got hit by a dump truck. She explains the truck driver ran away after seeing the boy getting crushed, but she has seen his body getting restored. She also tells him that she started looking into connect after learning about the urban legend of an undying man. She shows him the comment he left after seeing the doctor's question, and because of the comment, Hae-in has met with Mr. Kim and his men to share information. But because their motives were different, no information has come out from that meeting. She has learned that the connect is an experiment done by Jeonto Pharmaceuticals, which is the number one pharmaceutical company in the country. Dong-soo too confesses to her about his eye being transplanted to a serial killer, and that he sees everything the killer sees at random times. To Dong-soo's surprise, Hae-in takes off his eye patch and puts sunglasses on him, explaining that everyone is looking for a man with an eye patch. As the two detectives leave, Detective Choi comments that Jin-seop seems to be triggered by things that are unusual, since he seems to be more annoyed at the woman who came to help him for crossing the line than at the detectives who were interrogating him. Jin-seop plays Dong-soo's song at home, and confirms that it is because of the song that he gets the eye pain. He recognizes the voice to be Dong-soo's, and realizes that the eye is reacting to the voice. Dong-soo also sees Jin-seop listening to his song, and realizes the eye is responding to his song. Singer Z releases the cover of Dong-soo's song, which Dong-soo is delighted to hear. Jin-seop, on the other hand, visits the recording studio to know about the lyricist. He gets informed that the lyricist is anonymous, and the copyright fee is going straight to a donation, so there is no way to track the lyricist. The detectives, on the other hand, try to interrogate Big Guy. But because he is not cooperating, Detective Choi decides to release him. But he gets Detective Park to follow him. Hae-in listens to Min-sook making a phone call to Woo-jin asking to monitor Jin-seop, since he is the one who took Dong-soo's eye. She also hears that Jin-seop is terminally ill. Min-sook suddenly notices one of his guinea pigs is missing. As he looks for the guinea pig, Min-sook finds a tapping device. They realize that it was Hae-in who placed the device, remembering she coming to their office claiming her laptop battery is drained. They realize that Hae-in possibly know more about Connect than them, and she didn't really come for the information. Hae-in starts following Woo-jin. Hae-in informs about the conversation she overheard to Dong-soo. Dong-soo starts to see Jin-seop's notebook with his image drawn, and Jin-seop writes that he will find him. Jin-seop then shows him a photo of three girls, implying that they are going to be his next victims. Dong-soo stops by to listen to a street guitarist playing his song. He suddenly gets the eye pain but doesn't see any vision. He realizes Jin-seop is watching him and manages to point the vehicle he is in. So Jin-seop drives off, and when he tries to run after the vehicle, he gets stopped by the police. Detective Choi gets to him and takes him to the police to interrogate. Jin-seop, on the other hand, goes to see the doctor who transplanted the eye, and demands to know everything about the owner of the eye. With that, the episode ends. Thank you so much for stopping by. Hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you again next time.